Now let's conclude the chapter by looking at the relief that is sent to the church in Jerusalem here from Antioch. Verse 27, "And in these days, prophets came from Jerusalem to Antioch. Then one of them named Agabus stood up and showed by the Spirit that there was going to be a great famine throughout all the world, which also happened in the days of Claudius Caesar. Then the disciples, each according to his ability, determined to send relief to the brethren dwelling in Judea. This they also did and sent it to the elders by the hands of Barnabas and Saul." The world is a reference to the Roman Empire. This isn't a commentary on what was going on in South America at the time. But this guy, Claudius Caesar, his reign is marked by famine throughout the Roman Empire. Different years of famine depending on different places, Judea, Egypt, up in Europe. But that is what he is known by just in secular history. So this is predictive. The prophet says this famine is coming. And so much like in Genesis in the account of Joseph, when he predicted the famine, what was the plan? Well, let's stock up now. Let's save now. And so that's what's taking place here. Now, we do not have time to develop the issue of the gift of prophecy in the church. As we've done a couple times in the book of Acts, we're going to put a detailed section about the gift of prophecy on the website that you can read this week. We don't have it up yet, but we'll get it up there right away. And you can read about that. But I do want to say this. Notice it is predictive in nature. It is about the future. And it is not about a substitute for Scripture because we didn't have Scripture yet. This guy is not giving Scripture that applies to the entire body of Christ for the entire history of the church. It's a specific prophecy affecting a specific group of people at a specific time. And we'll leave it at that, and you can read more on that later. But you notice the changed lives. These Gentiles, why would Gentiles care about a bunch of Jews down there in Jerusalem? But they did, because they saw them as brothers and sisters in the Lord. It's a mark of the revival that had taken place, isn't it? Now, over the years of my Christian walk, I've heard a lot about these revivals that have hit the United States, different cities. Maybe you have too. Oh man, there's a revival going on over there in Florida, a revival over there in South Carolina. You know what those usually are? They're magic shows. Some good special effects, some sleight of hand, some trickery, performed by some guy in a building somewhere. See, I say that because when you hear about a revival in this city, you start asking questions. Oh, really? Has the crime rate dropped dramatically in that city? If I call Dish Network and DirecTV and ask them about their customers in that city, will they report that there was a rapid cancellation of all the pay-per-view skin channels for their customers? Are the bars shutting down because there's just no business in the strip clubs? Because if there's revival hitting the city, it's going to show itself in society. If it doesn't show itself in society, it's just a magic show somewhere in a church or an auditorium. We need to remember that. Are there just as many panhandlers and homeless people there, or all of a sudden they get ministered to and brought in off the streets? See, we ought to see some fruit if there's true revival. Now, there may not be a revival that hits Lake Elsinore today, but there can be a revival that happens in your heart and mine. Isaiah wrote, "For thus says the high and lofty one who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place with him who has a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones." If we will humble ourselves before the Lord, if we will take that yoke of his upon ourselves and learn of him, be his disciple, revival can happen right here. And when revival happens in the individual heart, and the individual hearts, plural, of those in this room, and in the individual hearts of the believers in the other churches here in Elsinore, and revival is going to hit Elsinore. And then it can spread to the county and the state and the entire nation. But where does it begin? Right here. Let's pray.